In today's video, I want to show you how to press your seams properly. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of ChatterboxQuilts.com. I'm the creator of The Quilter's Way. It's an online quilt club where members learn and grow in a fun and supportive community. Before I get into the details of today's video, I'd love it if you'd subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. Pressing seams in quilts. Lots of conversation about that, lots of discussion. I've had people ask me, how do I press my seams? Do I press my seams open? Do I press them to one side? How do I do it? What iron do I use? Lots of questions about this and lots of different ideas. Let me give you my opinion on that topic. First off, do I press my seams open? No, I don't. Sometimes I do, but very, very rarely. And there's reasons why I don't do that. First off, if I'm pressing my seams open and I want to stitch in the ditch, that becomes very tricky. Because when you press your seams open, all that's holding that seam together is the thread in the middle. There is no fabric there. So if I'm trying to stitch in the ditch, I'm actually stitching through a bunch of threads. Nothing to really hold those quilting stitches down. And there is a possibility I could actually break through some of those threads. So that's one reason why I don't press my seams open. I also feel that by pressing them to one side, you've actually got a stronger seam, especially when I go to stitch in the ditch or other kinds of quilting. So that's a short answer on why I do that. Probably also because when I was first taught to quilt in a class, I was told to press to one side, usually the dark side, right? Press to the dark side, Luke, right? Not always. There are times when you have to press to lighter fabric, but if it's possible, I always try and press to the darker fabric. Let's talk about what I use to press. Okay, first off, when I'm first pressing my fabric, before I've cut it up, I like to use some kind of starch or starch alternative to give some body to the fabric. It makes for more accurate and easier cuts. What I've been using for the last few months is called Easy Press Solution. It's by Acorn Precision Piecing Products. And you'll see me using it in today's demo when I'm doing the seams as well. But what I do is you can get it in a large gallon jug. Looks like moonshine in my studio, but it's not. And I put it in my spray bottle and I spray my fabric and I press it. And when I'm doing my seams, I'm going to be using this little applicator pen that they also have. And it's refillable. That's why I have this little bottle here. I can refill my applicator pen with that. But let's talk about pressing itself and what else I use besides the spray to do that. Well, I need an iron, right? And I've got to admit, I've gone back and forth between dry and steam. When I first started, I had a steam iron, but I didn't have water in it. So a dry iron, if you will. And then I went to steam because my piecing wasn't all that great and I would use the steam to release the fibers a bit and be able to adjust things. Now I'm going back to a dry iron again. And actually what I'm using, this is a fairly new iron I have in my studio. It's called a continental iron. And you can see it's a dry iron. I can't touch it because it's on. But it actually has no holes in it. It is not a steam iron. There are no holes in here. So I like using this one. It's got a good weight to it, but it's not the weight that is actually pressing my seams. It's actually the heat of the iron. And what I do like about this, though, is I don't have to worry about cleaning. I have to clean the bottom, but I don't have to worry about, you know, getting the water out of it and maybe getting sediments out of those holes. And you know how hard it is to clean those little holes in the bottom of a steam iron. I don't have that problem with this iron. So I'm using a dry iron, okay? First thing I want to do, I've got a little sample here, you can see. I've just two pieces of fabric seamed together. First thing I always do is I set my seams, okay? You just put your iron on for a few seconds, get that thread into the fabric. Off we go. Now, let's keep in mind, when we're talking here, we're talking pressing, not ironing. And some people don't understand the difference, okay? When you're ironing your clothes, you're going back and forth and everything. When you are pressing, you are not doing that. You're using pretty much an up and down motion, and you're not pressing hard. Again, it's the heat of the iron that's working, not the pressure on it. So I don't have to sit there and, you know, press down like this. Let me show you what I do. I'm opening up my seam, right? I'm pressing to one side, pressing towards the dark. And this has got a real difference between the light and dark. And then I just go from the center out and I just you know, press it out, making sure I'm not pushing away or anything like that. I'm just making sure it's all lying flat, that there's no wrinkles in the fabric. Occasionally you get little wrinkles up near the seam. I want to make sure that doesn't happen. Then I'm just taking my iron and I'm placing it down on top and I'm just leaving it for maybe 5 seconds, something like that. And when I'm done, off it comes. So my seam is down, but it could be flatter. So when I pick it up and you look at the back, you can see it's up a bit. I mean, it looks pretty good from the front, right? And for something like this, that may be okay. But when you start to put a whole bunch of seams together, if I'm pressing, and let's say there's a lot of seams here, I'm going to show you another example in a second there, you know, it becomes problematic if the seams are not lying as flat as possible. And that's where the easy press solution comes in, my applicator pen. So it's got a little felt tip on it, and I'm just drawing it along. It's like a magic marker almost, right? With the solution in it. And I move it along, and I'm just getting that solution into the fabric, and I'll let it sit for a few seconds because it actually does soak down in the fabric. And if you're working with a fabric and you've pressed it, or a seam I should say, and you've pressed it and it's not really flat at all, when you put this solution on, before I even put the iron back on it, you'll see how the fabric starts relaxing and going down. So it kind of works on its own, but it gets even better with the iron. So once I've got that in there, again, I'm just making sure it's all nice and flat, and I put the iron on again. Now, sometimes you'll see me move the iron over a little bit. I'm not actually putting the iron, like I'm just getting the iron in the right place. So it's not like I'm pushing down or anything like that. You don't want to do that. Okay, this is going to sit on here for a little bit. Okay, and it's hot. It's very hot. So it's down nice and flat. If I need to put it on longer, I can. Make sure my iron's up to where it should be too. Sometimes I don't have it quite as hot as I should when I'm working like this, but it's nice and flat. It's gone down there nice and flat, not a problem. And like I mentioned before, if you've got something like this, here's a little improv piece, but you can see I've got a couple seams coming across into this piece here. You can see I've got lots of extra little bits coming off it too. It's fraying a bit. I find when I use this easy press solution that the edges of the fabric don't fray as much either, which is kind of nice. But I'm setting my seam, and in this particular case, it's too hot for me to put my fingers on yet. When I move it out, I'm just going to move to the fabric that has the least amount of seams in it. So that's something else to keep in mind, is that if you are putting different ones together, look at how that's sitting up, like that doesn't want to lie down at all, does it? You want to press to the fabric that has the least amount of seams in, so that will be the least amount of bulk in your project. Down the bit. So you can see that I've pressed that, but you can see how much it's sitting up, right? Oh, it's a misbehaving little piece of fabric, isn't it? Now, I could leave my iron on longer if I wanted to, but let's go to this. This is the better part of it. Okay, so see what I told you before? You put that on, look at it. It's lying down already. If only my cats would behave like this. Maybe I need to start putting this on them, make them behave. Okay, so we're going to have that down there. And again, you want it to soak in. If it doesn't, if I don't let it sit long enough and I put my hot iron on it, you're going to hear a sizzle. Okay, and that means the product is still sitting on the top of the fabric and it's not doing much good because it's actually just getting stuck on the bottom of my iron. You don't want to do that. So just give it a little bit of time. Having said that, I might put it on sooner than later because, you know, you don't want to sit here forever. It's about 15 seconds. Put my iron on. And gosh, it's hard not to want to press, isn't it? Because we're so used to that, like pressing down on our iron. We seem to think that that's the way to go. And if you want to, you can. It's not going to hurt anything, but, you know, it doesn't make much of a difference. I'll leave this on here a little longer. So look at that. Look at how nice and flat that is, right? Amazing. So a great product to use for one thing, but remember, press to one side. Do not use your iron and, you know, go like this to get over. You don't want to do that, especially if you're working with bias edges. That is not the way to go. You just distort everything and it's a real waste if you've been really careful with your piecing and you wreck it with your ironing. There's a lot of things that go into quilting, right? Cutting properly, piecing properly, and ironing properly are three of the big ones that'll make a big difference in your project. So try dry ironing. If you're interested in the Acorn Precision Piecing products, I'll put a link in the description below so you can learn more about that. Loving using that product in my studio. You can see how well it works. Let me know, do you press your seams to one side or do you press them open? Or if you've been pressing them open, are you now going to change and press them to one side? Let me know in the comments below. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts. Thanks so much for watching today. If you like this video, please share it with a quilting friend. And if you're interested in getting more helpful quilting information, go to my website, chatterboxquilts.com.